thing. This was everything I need. Right, not so fond of change. I'm too caught up in my way of thinking. I get by on me. No, I don't need nobody. Yes, I was so naive. Somehow I'm still all in on me. Yeah, yeah. So every landscape photographer needs this lens. Now, tilt shift lenses are a particular lens, but they really fall under one pretty much category, and that's pretty much landscape photographers. Now, this doesn't mean that it's 100% for them though, because you can still use this as a regular wide angle lens, and you can pretty much even get some pretty cool and interesting creative shots with it. But also, real estate photography, this could be your best friend. Looking for a sign that I might be worth your time. What's going on, my friends? My name's Jason. I hope you're all doing well. If you haven't been to my channel before, I do a whole bunch of tips, tricks, tutorials on filmmaking, photography, and gear reviews, especially like the one we're going to be doing today. So, you know, subscribe to my YouTube channel if you already haven't, and also hit that like button because that helps push this video to other people onto the platform. Back into the video. So Laowa have produced a really interesting manual lens right here. This is the 15mm f4.5 tilt shift lens. Oh yeah, is my lens meant to do that? But this is a full metal design and it definitely has some heft to it. It pretty much weighs like a ton and it's built very, very good. Now, it doesn't particularly have the largest aperture of f4.5, but generally for landscapes, if you're wanting to dial in your aperture back to get the most amount of sharpness with your lens, so you won't be shooting any wider than 4.5 anyway, I would generally shoot around even 5.6, 8, or even 11 when it comes to landscape photography, because you want to dial in the sharpest image from your lens as possible. Now, if you're one of those people that are like, what the hell is a tilt shift lens and why does his lens do that? Well, if you don't know what a tilt shift lens is, well, pretty much like me a couple of years ago, I was like, tilt shift, what even the heck is a tilt shift lens? Well, this video is for you because essentially this assists you in removing some epic distortion from tall buildings or anything tall, any kind of subjects whatsoever. If you do take a photo of a building from ground level, you'll notice that the building edges aren't quite straight. Well, mainly because this is to do with perspective. You know, we see the buildings go up into a point and that's quite natural, but sometimes in photos, it's kind of not right. You actually want to be correcting that, which you can do in post, but essentially if you do it in post, you're going to be losing out on some resolution on your images because it's going to be cropping the image and then it won't look as, detailed as what you had before, whereas the tilt shift lens does that in camera, so you don't have to do it in post, which is really, really cool. So we're just coming in here to the lens chart and you can see already there's a lot of barrel distortion with this lens. This is at f4.5 as well, the minimum aperture, and you can see it's actually quite sharp in the center. That's a very good performance right there. And it is noticeably soft in the corners and in the edges. Stopping it down at f5.6 and same again, nice and tack sharp and still soft in the corners there. Stopping it down to f8. Same again, tack sharp in the corners. And it is starting to get a little bit better at f8 there in the sides and into the corners as well. And stopping it down to f11 directly into the middle, it does seem to have lost a little bit of contrast there. We'll just go back. Yeah, it's lost a little bit of contrast there in the center. It does still seem to be quite sharp though at f11 coming out to the corners, and it is noticeably sharper in the corners. And stopping it down to the most minimum aperture of f22. And it is noticeably less contrast in the center. It does still seem pretty sharp. And out to the corners or sides, it is actually quite sharp in the corners and in the sides, but you can see there's a little bit of fringing there that's been there the whole time as well. But overall, I must say, it's really good sharpness from this lens. So I just want to quickly jump in here and be sure to like this video, and also thank you to each and every one of you guys for subscribing to my YouTube channel, because we've pretty much hit 30,000 and I am so very appreciative of that. Thank you to every single one of you guys that have commenting. We've built a brilliant community on this YouTube channel, so let's keep that going. Back into the video. So the way it works is you move the lens in one particular direction, either up or down, to try and correct for that distortion in camera. Now you can see there is a massive difference between the regular shot and the adjusted shot. But you can pretty much change this from 0 degrees all the way up to 360 degrees, like any different angle you want. One of the great things as well is if you did want to do some landscape photography or video, you can turn your camera onto its landscape position or portrait style, and then you can adjust your lens to suit that portrait position. Now, like I said before, this could make a huge difference when you're a real estate photographer. This could be an incredible lens to your workflow, because if you want to keep those buildings nice and straight, or even those rooms, all the lines coming nice and straight and not too much distortion, this lens could be for you. And also, like I said earlier, is that it opens up some creative flow with this lens, because you can get some really cool, highly motivated perspective shots like Jordi Kowalczyk. I don't know if you've seen his stuff on Instagram. His stuff blows my mind. Incredible creative photographers of that bunch. Just such great work. But you can achieve a lot of those things with this lens. Okay, so one big thing that I feel like is a con of this lens, and I feel like it's pretty much unavoidable with any of these style lenses, and that is weather sealing. It's not fully weather sealed, and having this moving part in your lens, you could imagine there'd be some dust particles or moisture getting into the lens if you're not pretty much careful. And I don't suggest taking this lens to anywhere where there's like extreme locations of moisture and dust. So yeah, just be careful of that. Overall, the lens feels super good, super quality, like it's very high quality build. But one of the biggest things as well is that the lens optical part protrudes outside the body. So this could be quite dangerous for scratching the lens element itself. It doesn't have a lens flare protector like the 14mm. You can see it's built in. So that is really cool. Would be nice if they did add that on, because they're very similar. Ooh, I almost hit the element there. See what I mean? Very similar design, because it is a metal lens cap. And I really wish they actually put this on there, but hey, that doesn't matter. Just gotta be careful with that. So if you have any questions about this lens, just shout out, let me know in the comment section below, and I'll try and answer them as best as possible. As well, try and reach out to my Instagram, Jason Morris Photo Cinema, and I'll try and answer any questions. Like I said, I've been taking, some requests on what kind of videos you guys actually want to see as well. So comment below if you do want to see some style of video, something in particular you want me to review, just let me know and I'll see if I can make that happen. Other than that, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video or found it useful or just entertaining. If you did, hit that like button. That would be absolutely amazing. Like I said, comment below if you do have any questions on this, or even if you have a tilt shift lens, what are your thoughts on tilt shift lenses? And yes, subscribe to my YouTube channel if you already haven't. Hit that bell notification so you can be notified when my next videos come out. All right, guys, I'll see you in the next one. All right, let's get it. Take post beef for granted. I plan to keep it stress-free, live and die young, I leave it on the canvases.